Happening DC&D family, welcome back to another reaction. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do Seether with one of the best remakes of a song I think out there. Top five. He done George Michael's Careless Whisper and absolutely kills it. Am I being biased because he's actually South African? Maybe. Don't think a lot of yous knew that. Lead singer of Seether is South African. But the fans out there that know Seether, who know their original name used to be Sarin Gas back in the day. But America forced them to change the name because it wasn't politically correct, whatever. All that bollocks. So, I haven't actually done a video to this. I know there's no actual video to it, and I've been looking for a while to do a good live version. It's all cell phones, mobile phone recordings. There's no actual proper recorded live version. Most of the audio sucks. Like when it gets really loud because he takes it up there, the mic like starts blanking out and it just gives us like weird, nah. So we'll just do original audio. And let me know what you thought if you've never heard of Seether, Careless Whisper. If you're a George Michael fan, have an open mind about it. Listen to it. It is a lot heavier, sadder, filled with pain more. He like turns it all around to like, So, if you're new, let me know in the comments what you thought about it. And yeah, smash the subscribe button. Appreciate it. Let's go. Been a long time. I was just enjoying myself, okay? This is one of the bands that are out there that never really exploded. They got some massive hits, but the band itself never really... But they've got a cult following. Hardcore cult following. Seether is... They never fully went... Which, I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing. Yeah, but they did deserve to. I think they were very underrated for how brilliant they are. I mean, his original work is, he's got some fantastic original work out there. Some of his Sarin Gas days, woo, deep. Maybe I should look for one of them, or the one that I like the most. I think I'll do that.
Should have known better than to cheat a friend and waste the chance that I've been given. So I'm never gonna dance again. The way I dance with you.
Am I right in saying he completely changed the song to his own style, but kept true to it? I think so. I think he did. Because I've heard George Michael plays all the time on the radio at work. Oh, typical radio station. Repeat, 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 repeat. That's all they do with the radio station. Repeat, repeat, repeat. It's like they've got 10 songs and that's all they play for a whole year. Blech. Sucks. But besides that, I can rant about radio stations all day long. I think he just gave the song more depth, more feeling. That's what I think. If that's the first time you've heard it, what do you think? Especially if you're a George Michael fan, and you know, let me know. Appreciate it. Hope you guys have a fantastic day, and I won't waste any more of your time. Peace out, YouTube.